you are watching this channel right now, you already know you are spending some downtime with the meal. I hope you all are having a great day today, especially with everything going on in the world, man. Let me tell you something. We got some enjoyment that's out there because, just in case you didn't know, Transformers War for Cybertron, the three-part Netflix trilogy, is now available. And I'm going to give you my review, my non-spoiler review, of the first episode in the three-part trilogy. Before we get into that review, if you're new to this channel and if you like the content that I produce, don't forget to hit that like button. And also, if you want to be notified every time I produce a new video, hit that notification bell, or in this case, transform that notification bell. Man, you'll be notified every time I produce a new video on this channel. Also, don't forget, down here in the corner, if you want to follow me on Twitter, that's my address. Feel free to follow me. I post stuff on there that you don't see on YouTube, so check me out. Anyway, now it is time for the Transformers War for Cybertron. Oh my God. So I gotta tell you, I wasn't really sure what to expect with this, but based on the trailer, I knew the visuals were gonna be good, and the visuals were amazing. I will tell you that visually, you will not be disappointed with this first trilogy that came out. The visuals are fantastic. I'm truly impressed with it. It really gives you that G1 look from the 80s cartoons. All of the Transformers, while they're in robot mode, they look very, very close to how they looked in the 80s G1 cartoon, and it looks very, very impressive. Now, another thing that you'll want to keep in mind while you're watching this, these are 6 episodes in each part of the trilogy. So the first part of the trilogy only had 6 episodes. They're about 20 minutes long, so you can binge watch these real quick. It doesn't take long at all. Action-wise, the action is more so kind of bookended. You get a lot of action at the beginning, and then you get a lot of action at the end. But right in the middle, it's a little slow, but it's still good. So I would say just keep with it, keep watching it. It's not going to put you to sleep. But, you know, all of the stuff that you liked from the early Transformers, it's things like the sounds of them transforming, like, and stuff like that, you're going to love it. It's all in here. They don't have the original actors' voices, like Peter Cullen and Frank Welker voicing Optimus Prime and Megatron, respectively. That being said, the voice actors that they do have are on point, and they do a great job. Whoever is voicing Megatron, it actually sounds closer to the version of Megatron from the Transformers 1 Michael Bay. I think it was Hugo Weaving who voiced Megatron in that one. And it sounds pretty good. Megatron looks darker. And really, the truth is, the series as a whole just has a darker feel. Similar to the original Transformers movie that came out in the theaters, not the Michael Bay movie, but the actual animated movie that came out back in the 80s where Prime died. That one, it has a darker feel like that. Now, aside from all of that, I think you'll really enjoy this, but there is one thing. I am Optimus Prime, and I am here to tell you that in this first part of the Netflix Transformers War for Cybertron, I am not portrayed as the heroic leader that you have come to know and love. In fact, in this trilogy, I am not portrayed as I should be. I am portrayed as weak, and Megatron is really kicking my can all over the place. In fact, however, if you stick around to the end of the first part of the trilogy, you'll see that I do have a moment of redemption, and I am so hoping that by the next part of this three-part trilogy that I will become the Autobot leader that you know and love. And like I say, that is so true. Optimus Prime, it's like the direction they went with him, they made him look a little weak in the early goings. But that being said, you know, there was a moment of redemption at the end. I'm not going to give away what happens, but just stay tuned. Hopefully it gets better with Optimus Prime. I'm a huge Prime fan. But that's pretty much the biggest points about this. It's interesting, too, when you think about this particular series and where it took place and where it is now, where we are now time-wise. You know, of course, we have Siri, we have Alexa as our personal assistants. Tony Stark had Jarvis. The Transformers had digital assistants before digital assistants became popular with Teletran 1. And just hearing that all over again, man, it was just crazy hearing Teletran 1 all over again, because I forgot all about Teletran 1 and how they use that all the time. But you're gonna love the voices for certain characters like Starscream. He sounds pretty much like he did in the early 80s cartoon. I like what they did with Soundwave. Soundwave always had that modulated voice like from the original, but they did something a little bit more high tech in this version, and I thought it was fantastic. So overall, I would give this a B plus. I think it was good. It was not great, but it was good. I think you'll like it. Anyway, that was my review for Transformers: The War for Cybertron, and it's on Netflix right now. Have you seen this? What do you think about it? This is a great time to post your thoughts down in the comments below. Let's have a conversation about it. While you're having a conversation about it, let me know what you think about Optimus Prime. Do you think it was great the way they portrayed him? Is that accurate? Even though this is like before he became the Autobot leader that we know and love. What do you think about that? Let's talk about it down in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video. On the way out, if you like the video, hit that like button. Likes really help the channel out in a big way. Tell your friends about Downtime with Demille. I hope you all have a fantastic Friday. If you can see this video, you are truly blessed, man. Believe it. Days and ages we are living in right now. And as always, what are you gonna do in your downtime? Peace. Subscribe!